praise to the Most High.
This is spiritual warfare.
That's what it means by being born again, to transform and renew your mind. We have to subdue what we think and lean on the word of God.
Because how we've been doing it because we've been running to dead ends all day long. Scattered us abroad and took from our land. Serve our enemies and know we're not friends. Trying to live peaceable with all men.
Lord, because again, we cast away all my sins. First Kings chapter 8, I repent. From warmonging, used to get bent. All praises, he let me repent.
Died for the lost sheep, the remnant. Was a little boy, became a real man. First Kings 2 and 2 to witness. Can't you see I'm by this business?
I understand it comes from this Bible, right? So, when it says that precept must be upon precept, the Bible answers itself. It's going to give you the
truth. 1 John 5 and 3 show our love. All praises to God be above. Show mercy, he could have shed blood.
But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God, so we are out here giving you the word of God, which is going to nourish your spirit. Above all people,
we are the greatest nation that walks the earth. God is saying we are above everyone that walks the earth right now.
Guess what? When you stop keeping the love in
my sword and in my shield, and we're ready for
but
the fight, standing strong in the
we
Lord
can't be
and the
we're
power
not
of His might.
We're not here trying to wake up so far, because
I'm warring in the spirit,
and Native American Indians, us, and showing them the love of God.
Only the tribes of Israel.
Right.
And I told them John 3:16 says,
right,
whomsoever shall believe
right.
in Him should not perish. And I felt like, I think Paul, he was speaking about the Jew inwardly.
What's your name again, bro?
Milo.
You been out here for a minute. Don't go nowhere, soldier. You been out here for a minute listening. And a lot of things been coming out, dealing with mainly repentance. Because we're a broken people. That's what you're looking at. A broken and destroyed people. When you look at the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans on the sign, you're looking at the house of broken toys in America.
Yes.
All right?
Right.
Whether we in South America or in North America, even in scattered in Ghana and west coast of Africa, different parts of Africa, we are broken people, all right?
Right.
So, mind you, when you look at this sign, it's not a black or white thing, all right? Your spirit has to bear witness with this Bible, all
right?
Go to Romans chapter 8, verse 16, real quick, all right? Because we're reading a lot of precepts to you, but we need you to understand those precepts. And we need our people to understand that we are in the last days and we must repent as a nation of people.
Right.
All right? Let me ask you something, Milo. When you check on an application, what do you check?
You're talking about like a job application?
Yeah.
Hispanic.
Hispanic, okay. You Israel. I don't know why you were talking about Japanese earlier.
That's just what they don't have that on there.
Right, okay. All right. Hold it. Come on.
The book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 16.
Bring it out.
The spirit itself bears witness with our spirit.
So the spirit of this Bible bear witness with our spirit. Come on.
That we are the children of God.
That we are the children of God. When we read Deuteronomy 28 and 68, it talks about the transatlantic slave trade. All right? When you read about a destroyed nation of people that has been taken advantage of and have never been able to have been repaid or recompensed or reparated for the atrocities, you're looking at the 12 tribes of Israel.
Yes,
all right?
Right.
Because our only redeemer is the Lord.
Right, right.
The Lord is the one that's going to redeem us. All
right?
Give me that one, Isaiah chapter 33 and verse 22. Because we must read the Bible precept upon precept. We can't wait on man to give us the understanding. We must read the scriptures and get our understanding. You understand that, Milo? You have to start reading these scriptures and understand, is this making sense? Is your spirit bearing witness? All right, come on.
The book of Isaiah chapter 33 verse 22. For the Lord is our judge.
So the Lord is our judge. He's the one that's going to recompense any tribulation that was given to us. He's the one that's going to recompense all the hate that was done to our people, all the tribulation that we've been through as a nation, all the atrocities and the rape, robbing, pillaging of our people. We at the bottom, he's the one that's going to judge the matter to put us back in our rightful place. Come on.
For the Lord is our judge. The Lord is our lawgiver.
So he's going to give us the laws again in the wilderness. When we get in the wilderness, he's going to speak to us face to face and give us the laws once again. Come on.
The Lord is our King.
Who's the King?
Christ.
Who's the King?
Christ.
Who's the King?
Christ.
Christ, the black Messiah, is our King.
That's right? Right.
Come on.
He will save us.
Who?
He will save us.
He will save us. He will save us. So that's showing you, you're looking at a people that's not ignorant. You, these men on this side, we're not ignorant to the fact that we in captivity. We're not ignorant that when we take out our money, our slave master, our oppressor's face is on the money.
Yes, all right? Right?
You've been a victim of America, whether you realize it or not. We're not saying to sit down and wait for America to give you anything, because repentance is picking yourself up and not waiting on anything. Yes, all right? Because right. The white man can't, if you're waiting for the white man to convince you to repent, it's never going to happen.
Hey.
All right? We're waiting for the 12 tribes of Israel to repent and pick up themselves. You ever heard, Milo, you ever heard that saying that they say, pick up yourself by your bootstraps? You ever heard that saying? That saying is saying that our people have gotten a docile, lazy spirit on us. All right? They call it, I forgot what they call that. I'm trying to leave a job and you just sit there. Complacent. You got complacent. We've gotten complacent in America, all right? We have not yet learned the value of true repentance. Because when you repent, it comes with identity. It comes with pride. It comes with confidence. It comes with wisdom, all right? Because these are basic things that our people don't have, all right? That's why when we get shot down in the street, all we know what to do is what we've seen Martin Luther King and all these other previous activists do, is just march. Instead of saying, you know what? Let's search this Bible and see what we're supposed to be doing. Because what we're supposed to be doing is repenting, all right?
That's right.
So now, let's go to,
I just wanted to know what you guys were about and your mission.
Okay.
Just kind of clear what, you know, my questions were and all that.
Okay.
Thank you for your time.
All right. Take care, Milo. So let's go to Ezekiel chapter 3 and verse 4. Because we out here teaching the 12 tribes of Israel that they must repent and turn back to the commandments of God. Here we are today on the Day of Atonement teaching our people repentance and teaching our people to come back to the Heavenly Father through their obedience, all right?
Yes,
you can't never tell no woman you love her and then you whoop her ass every day, all right?
Right.
You can't tell a woman you love her and cheat on her every day, because at the end of the day, if you really love her, you will show with your actions. So likewise in repentance in these last days, the Most High wants us to show through our actions that we love Him. The Most High wants us to show through our actions that we want to repent.
Right.
Hey, brother, let me ask you something, brother. Brother, let me ask you something. What is repentance? Because the Christian church teaches us what repentance is, but I'm pretty sure you're looking at us and you know that we know what repentance is, but we want to know what your definition is. Turn away.
John.
Give me that.
1 John 3, 4.
You say what? To turn away?
Yeah.
All right, turn away from what? Okay, sin. So now, you might not know this, but today is the Day of Atonement. The Day of Atonement. All true Christians are supposed to keep the Day of Atonement.
That's
if you
right.
call yourself a true Christian, you're supposed to know what the Day of Atonement is.
Right.
Today is the day where the Lord gives you a clean slate with any type of sins that you might have failed, all right? Before you read that, let me get 1 Kings 8 and 47. No, 46, right?
Sir,
come on. 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 46.
Bring it out.
If they sin against thee, for there is no man that sinneth not.
You see that? There's no man that sinneth not. That all of us have fallen short of the glory of God. We read that in the Christian church and think that means after you done committed adultery with the pastor done committed adultery with the first lady and the deacon slept with this other woman in the church, committed adultery on his wife. You familiar with that, brother? You familiar with that?
Yeah.
All right. So, because the church I came from, that's what went down, all right? They used to go to these conferences. And these conferences, they used to be big time whoremongers. They used to go traveling, the deacons and the bishops and all these people, they used to go to these conferences, Christian conferences, and be big time whoremongers.
That's right.
All right? And that's the life of filth that we came out of. But what we saying is we have to acknowledge our sins and turn away from them, all right? Turn away from your iniquities. That's what our people have not yet done. That's why we in the condition we in now, all right? Now you're in trouble because of Trump in office.
That's
now
right.
You're in trouble because voting done failure. Obama just liberated the homosexuals. He ain't do nothing for your black behind.
Right.
You understand? But at the end of the day, we got to ask ourselves, what are we doing to really do true repentance? What are we doing to really seek true repentance, all right? Read what you got.
1 Kings chapter 8, verse 46. And if they sin against thee, for there's no man that sinneth not.
You see that? There's no man that sinneth not. So that's the reason why I pulled that precept, because for some reason, in these last days, we fail to realize when brothers and sisters come up, that when we talk about repentance, that they think we perfect men that never failed before. All right? The Lord said it's a blessing that our foot have not slipped, meaning what? Fell deep into iniquity. Fell headlong and no way up. All right? So that's what we're trying to teach our people, to come back to the commandments of God.
Yes,
so
right.
Now, what's your name, brother?
Derek.
Derek?
Yeah.
You just got off work, bro?
Yeah.
Come over here, bro. It was a hard day at work.
Yeah.
My name is Don. It's a hard day at work?
Yeah.
What kind of work you do? You don't mind me asking?
Cleaning cars.
Cleaning cars. All right. Another day, huh?
Yeah, another day.
So what? Did you make enough to pay your bills? It's Friday.
Nah, I ain't get paid.
Give me Hebrews chapter 3:8. You say what?
Nah, I ain't get paid today.
You ain't get paid today. When they pay you?
On Friday.
Yeah, but today Friday.
Yeah, I don't tell them Friday.
Oh, okay. Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Damn. Hey, you know what's sad about that? You're right, because you don't want to know that you in downtown, bro. Yeah, you get paid on another day, brother. So read what you got. The reason why we pull in these scriptures is to wake our people up out of this lower state of not reading this Bible. Our prayer is that you understand that you are of the nation of Israel. Because what? Your father's what? An African American?
No.
Where your father from?
He's Houston.
Okay, so that means he's an African American.
Yeah.
So-called African American.
Yeah.
So that means you would be from the tribe of Judah.
I misunderstood.
Okay, yeah. So read what you got.
I misunderstood what you said.
Okay, yeah. So read what you got.
The book of Baruch, chapter 3 and verse 8.
Bring it out.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
You know what's sad about that? The scriptures say, behold, we are yet this day in our captivity. Let me let you know something, bro. Derek, right?
Yeah.
Derek, I'm gonna tell you something, bro. When we work, you cash your check, you look at the money, and it's just enough to pay the bills. You ever heard that old saying, I'm working like a Hebrew slave?
Yeah.
Bro, you the Hebrew slave for real.
Yeah, that's right.
You the real Hebrew. You the ones that walked in Egypt and was being oppressed, and the Lord brought up out of Egypt.
Right.
You are those people. Come on. Read it again.
Baruch chapter 3 verse 8. Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse, and to be subject to payments.
That's the part. And to be subject to payment. That's called bills.
Right.
All right? Because when we were in rulership, all nations paid tribute to us.
Right.
But in these last days, we on the bottom. The money that's in your hand, in your pocket, when you look at it, it's got your oppressor, the one that raped, robbed, and pillaged your whole nation, face on it. And you got to take that money, that piece of paper, which ain't even got no value to it. It ain't even a gold shekel. It's just a piece of paper, and it got value to it because the white man said it's valuable. And you go and give it to another oppressor. Because at the end of the day, the scriptures say we subject to payment. But we out here to teach our people to repent, because it's so easy for the other nations to take heed to instruction. But for some reason, we don't like instruction as a people. All right? That's why we out here to teach instruction. Teach our people how to get right. How to get set back on the right path. Give me Ezekiel. Go back to Ezekiel chapter 3 and verse 4. That's what we're trying to do, Derek. We're trying to teach our people to get back on the right path and get back in favor with the Lord. Because our people are not in favor with the Lord. This is what it looks like when the Lord mad at you. We got more brothers out here and sisters that's in downtown that's homeless than anything, all right? That's what we got out here. All right, come on.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 4. And he said unto me, son of man, go, get thee a Israel and speak with my words.
So when the Bible says speak with my words, let me ask you something, Derek. How do you know if we're speaking with God's word? How do you know? Because we just read in Ezekiel, he says, speak with my word. How do you know?
As long as I know, it's just speaking by the Spirit.
Well, you know, to speak with God's words, it has to be backed by God. So when we read in Ezekiel, when it said, speak unto him my words, that means pull the scripture that's pertaining to the topic and read that scripture. You understand what I just said?
Yeah.
So that's why he said, speak unto them, read it again.
And he said unto me, son of man, go, get thee unto the house of Israel and speak with my words unto them.
Speak unto them my words, You see that? Not the pastor. Banana bread. Yeah, one day I put banana bread in the oven. Bring your money. I'm a whoremonger. You see what I'm saying? That's how I go in the Christian church.
That's right.
I was there. I can speak on it. So in these last days, we have to examine ourselves to understand what true repentance is. All right, read it again.
Ezekiel chapter 3 and verse 4. And he said unto me, son of man, go, get thee unto the house of Israel, and speak with my words unto them. For thou art not sent to a people of a strange speech.
So when he says thou art not sent to a people of a strange speech, that's talking about you sent to these people. You're not sent to the Chinese and the Arabs. You sent to the people that speak your language. All right? So if you was from Haiti, you would speak French, Creole. So you would be able to communicate with the tribe of Levi. You understand? If you're from the tribe of Issachar, you would be able to speak Spanish to be able to if you was translate to the so-called Mexicans, all right? Because they're of the 12 tribes of Israel as well, all right? So read on.
And of a hard language, but to the house of Israel, not to many people of a strange speech, and of a hard language, whose words thou canst not understand.
So that's what we out here to try to compel you to repent. We out here trying to get our people to understand the words of this Bible. Understand what the Lord is calling us to do in these last days, all right? So give me Revelation chapter 3 and verse 17. Because we out here, earlier we was dealing with a guy named Milo. And Milo was wishy-washy. He didn't know what he wanted to do. He didn't know if he was on the sign. He didn't know if he wasn't on the sign. But the point is, because at the end of the day, we're going to make all nations keep the commandments. We're going to make them do it. But you as the priest got to get right first. All right? Come on.
The book of Revelation, chapter 3, verse 17. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable.
You see that? Because our people think they got it good in America. Our people like, I got paid today. I'm good. Look, I'm about to go home and eat some defiled food. But the Lord said what? Read it again.
Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable.
You see that? He said thou art wretched and miserable. Why? Because the whole earth belong to you. The same person that paid you was supposed to be, you supposed to be over them. What is it, Misty Car Wash? So look, bro, the owner, the CEO of Misty Car Wash is supposed to be working for you.
Right.
Did you hear what I just said?
Bring it up.
That's what the Lord, our inheritance, that's what the Lord is telling our people.
Right.
You don't even understand that you of the, if you on this, you the 12 tribes of Israel, the earth belong to you.
That's
all you're doing is waiting for the Lord to come and get, you get your check.
That's right.
That's what we telling our people. It's like, you ever seen that movie, Willy Wonka? I know it's a kids movie, brother, but you know what movie I'm talking about, right? You remember that golden ticket? You seen how that white woman looked when she got that golden ticket? Because she understood that it was a promise of riches to her. Anything she wanted. We don't want the car. We don't want the Lexus. We don't want the $1 million. We want the earth.
That's right.
Everything on it.
That's right.
Including the other nations.
Bring
they
it
are
out.
Slaves. When Christ Bring comes, they going to, we going to inherit them. Just like you was inherited. Did you know that, brother? Your foremothers and forefathers was inherited by the so-called slave master. That was the first Christmas gift. Derek, you hear me, bro?
Yeah, yeah.
Did you know that, though?
Nah.
You know that, brother?
Nah, I'm not really, I have a question personally. Down here, I got a different question.
Okay, you got a question.
Yeah, my question was, it was four Israelite guys, and I was concerned about the discord between blacks and whites. So my question was, can a white man or woman inherit the kingdom of heaven?
That's a good question. That's a good question. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 1, all right? Because, let me ask you something. All right, brother. What's your name, brother?
Lewis.
Yeah. So where were you at when you seen them, brother?
Yeah, I actually.
He's about one block away.
Bus stop.
You was at the bus stop.
Yes, sir.
But you ain't see them in there, cause we don't go in there. So when did you see them?
They walked through the bus station.
Oh, they walked through the bus station. Yeah. You got the flyer and yeah. Then you heard.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so about 200-300 feet away, 400 feet away. All right. So you came to inquire. Is white people gonna be in the kingdom?
Nah, because I mean I'm spiritual and I abide in the word, but they were saying like only the tribes of Israel.
Right.
And I told them John 3:16 says,
right,
whomsoever shall believe right. in him should not perish. And I felt like I think Paul he was speaking about the Jew inwardly. You know, he was saying that the Jew is inwardly. It's no longer a color thing anymore. It's like inwardly, so spirit, the spirit of God that will compel you to make it to heaven. You know, not so much of your skin race, but your works, which is the faith, keeping the law.
All right. So, you're familiar with the Bible because you said the word is in you.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we about to read the book of Acts, chapter what is it?
Chapter 2 and verse 21.
So is that in the Old Testament or in the New Testament?
This is the New Testament, I'm talking about.
Right. Come on.
Acts chapter 2 verse 21. And it shall come to pass that whosoever.
Uh-oh. That's what you was quoting earlier, huh?
Yes,
whosoever, come on.
Shall
quote. Look, the brother smiling. He said, yeah, I heard my word. That's the word. That's what I wanted right there, brother. Come on.
Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Come on.
Ye men of Israel. Ye men of Israel. Hear these words.
What you got to say, brother?
So, but he's also.
It said, men of Israel.
Is Israel considered a Jew?
It said, ye men of Israel. Let's deal with this right here. Because you smiled, but the smile turned off when we got to the end of this one. Read it again for the brother. Look, I want you to smile the whole time, brother, when I'm reading the scripture.
Smiling in my heart.
Come on. Now smile outwardly, like you was doing earlier. Come on.
That's Acts right. chapter 2, verse 21. And it shall come to pass.
Watch this, brother. I'm about to smile the whole time this scripture being read, because I know I'm an Israelite.
That's right. Yeah. Bring it up.
It shall come to pass. That whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Ye men of Israel, hear these words.
You see that? Ye men of Israel, hear these words. So now, let's deal with the point. You came from where you was at.
Yes, sir.
Life gave you a mission. And you was over there executing the mission. And you put that mission on pause to come over here to find out about the white man.
I wasn't really concerned about it. I was more like, because you put the love everybody as yourself, so I feel like even white people can fulfill the law.
Okay.
Which is keep the commandments.
Can I ask you a question? Go
yes,
to
sir.
The one I wanted. Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1. Can I ask you a question? Why you ain't asked about the Chinese man?
All colors can make it. I feel like.
I'm asking you why you ain't asked about the Chinese man when you came up here.
Because me and the brothers was talking about, this why, because I usually catch the Israelites on YouTube. So I always seen them from different cities saying, the white man. So this is my first time seeing y'all in person in YouTube.
Oh, okay, I understand. All right. All right, you justified on. You got out of that one. Hey, you got out of that headlock, because I said, damn, why this brother ain't asked about the Arab man? Why he ain't asked about the Chinese man? Why is he only worried about the one that whooped his back, raped his mother,
bring it up,
and
bring
still up. Have not gave you your 40 acres and a mill,
right.
Which would equate to about $3 million a day.
That's right.
All right, come on.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 14, verse 1.
Here's your answer, all right? I want you to smile like you, because this is the word of God, brother.
Amen.
We're reading the word of God.
Bring
so
it up.
Gonna give me an amen after I read the scripture?
I'm gonna give you amen if it's the word.
All right, come on, it's the word, come on.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob.
So now the Lord, he will have mercy on Jacob, come on.
And will yet choose Israel.
So he will choose the Israelites, come on.
And set them in their own land.
That's the kingdom. That's the kingdom. Set them in their own land, come on.
And the strangers shall be joined with them, and they shall cleave to the house of Jacob, and the people shall take them.
So now it says in the strangers, that's the other nations. That's the ones that you, look, now you smiling. Oh, okay, all right. So when you heard that the other nations gonna be in the kingdom, you smiling now, come on.
And the people shall take them and bring them to their place, and the house of Israel shall possess them.
Shall possess them. Come on.
In the land of the Lord.
In Jerusalem.
For servants and handmaids.
They're going to be slaves just like you were slaves in America. So they're going to be there.
Right.
But wait. Let me fully answer it. So one, your oppressors will be in the kingdom.
Right.
The white man, the Chinese man, the Arab man, these other nations will be in the kingdom,
right.
But they will be there on a serving class,
right.
Like you. Like you in America today. You're on a serving class.
Right. Look it up.
All right, you ever heard that word, blue collar worker?
Yes, sir.
You're a blue collar worker. Right. All right? That's what, you don't work in these high rises making $5 million deals and make $1 million in salary annually.
You right about that, man.
All right, your oppressors do that.
Not yet.
And they have yet. You say what?
Not yet.
You Hispanic descent?
Yes, I am.
You ain't never gonna make that here in this captivity.
That's right.
Oh, come on, read it again.
And the people shall take them and bring them to their place.
So we gonna take the white man, the Chinese man, the Arab man, and bring them to their place. Come on.
And the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids.
You see that? And we're going to possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids. Come on.
And they shall take them captives whose captives they were.
You see that? We're going to take them captive. You're Hispanic descent, right? Latino. So when you examine history, 1492, our people were conquered by the conquistadors, right? That's how you learn Spanish. So, likewise, that's how you learn English, from your oppressors.
Yes, sir.
So, the scriptures say we're going to take them captives whose captives we were. Come on.
And they shall rule over their oppressors.
The scriptures say we're going to rule over our oppressors. All right? So, read that one more time, that whole verse, one more time. It's something else I want to show in that. Read.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 2. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place, and the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids.
So we're going to possess them in the house of the Lord for servants and handmaids. Get me Revelation chapter 11 and verse 2.
Bring it on.
Give me a Revelation chapter 11 verse 2. Read that.
Bring it on.
Revelation chapter 11 verse 2.
Bring it on.
But the court which is without the temple, leave out.
So the court which is without the temple, leave out. Come on.
And measure it not. For it is given unto the Gentiles.
So you see that? So they ain't even gonna be in the temple. They ain't dealing with none of that. Give me that one in Revelation 22:21. You know what I mean? 12 gates. Because at the end of the day, we have to examine what we gonna do to get the kingdom.
Right.
You ain't even earned your spot in the kingdom yet, because you gotta keep God's commandments.
That's right.
You have to endure to the end. All of us have to endure. Brother, you ain't earned your spot, but you trying to get the white man's spot in there.
Right. Look it out.
You don't see that?
I feel like I'm filled with the Holy Spirit.
Come on, brother. We ain't talking about feeling. We talking about actual things that you see. You came over here asking about salvation for the other nations. What about salvation for you?
That's right.
You said what?
I said I have my salvation.
You have your salvation already.
I'm sanctified and holy.
Okay, let's go to, hold on. Let's go to, hold that one, 12 gates, Revelation 21. Give me Matthew 24 and 13.
Bring it up. Brother,
look, what you just said is not of the Lord.
That's right.
Not of the Lord.
I'm going to read it. I want to hear amen from you after I read it too.
Brother,
the book of Matthew, chapter 24 and verse 13.
Hold on, I'm going to deal with you in a minute. Hold on, come on.
But he, that's but he that shall endure until the end.
To the what?
Until the end.
Is the end here yet? No, all right then, come on.
The same shall be saved.
You ain't saved yet.
Right.
I need to get an amen from you.
I'm saying,
can I get an amen?
Amen.
All right, then. You know what amen means?
Amen means truth.
No, it means let it be done.
That's right. Truth, let it be done.
Yeah.
You know.
I have to endure.
Yes, so how you know when the end gonna be here? You know, no, it's people can pass any day.
You right.
And
we
that don't mean
know.
That they endure to the
you
end.
You right. Let's go to Revelation chapter 3 and verse 17. Go back over
Bring
there.
It up.
Because at the end of the day, we have to go scriptural. Right. We ain't TD Jakes. We don't want your money. We
right.
want you to get right.
Amen.
All right, come on.
Revelation chapter 3 verse 17. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing. And knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked. I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, and white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, and that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear.
You see that? Because that's talking about enduring. That's talking about enduring right there. Come on.
And anoint thine eyes with eyesight, that thou mayest see.
Anoint thy eyes that you may see this word, that you may see that Christ is a black man that came from the tribe of the nation of Israel only.
That's right.
That's what the scriptures say. We just read it in Revelation, Isaiah 14. Come on.
Right.
Verse 19. As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Be zealous therefore and repent.
You see that? Be zealous and repent. That don't mean do your own thing. That don't mean repent how you want to. You have to keep God's commandments. Come on.
Right.
Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him.
So now he said, behold, I knock. Because what? Come into this Bible. Start keeping God's commandments.
Amen.
And he said, I will sup with you. Come on.
And he with me, to him that overcometh, will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne.
That's heavy right there, because you know what that's showing you? That Christ, the black Messiah, endured all temptation. He was a man that walked the earth. He came from the seed, the sperm of Joseph, and he walked as a man, and he went through the tribulations and the trials you went through, and he endured. All right, today's the Day of Atonement. That means that you can get right. All right, come on.
Verse 22, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches.
You see that? So he that have an ear, let him hear.
Amen.
Because what we talking about, we talking about repentance. We talking about enduring. We talking about the 12 tribes of Israel getting the kingdom. Because it belongs to you. It's your inheritance.
Right.
All right? That's what the earth is. It's your inheritance.
Now you will see the treatment of God. We are not black men. We are Israelites.
Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.